Yes, we will. And I also believe that it's unfortunate. For example, in South Africa, the government has opened an anti-competition inquiry over sports rights, particularly English Premier League. Because if you have a dominant monopoly, okay, for example, in India, no monopoly would be allowed to hold the rights because it is preventing the entry of others. Okay, so I'm expecting that very soon the Nigerian government will take the same approach to key rights such as the English Premier League, that they should be opened up. And I'm calling for them to be opened up. You cannot have a dominant predatory monopoly. So I'll give you an example. I'm in the mobile business, okay? I have a cell phone. If you buy a cell phone and you're on MTN and the phone is yours, if you decide to move from MTN, does the phone stop working? Why is it that for pay TV, that you are made to buy the price of the decoder, but no other operator can come on the decoder? You cannot choose. You can take your SIM card out of the phone, right? And you can put Glow in your phone, but you can't change your pay TV operator.
No.
Even though they made you pay for the decoder, why didn't they give you? Do you see? It's wrong. Okay. In the UK, when British Telecom started Sport, BT Sport, I have a decoder in my house for Sky. The regulator required Sky to open up its decoders to competitors. These are the things that have prevented the entrance of others. Because you're making somebody make a capital investment in their house. Okay? Yeah. And the industry is not being properly regulated. So these are some of the things now. For example, as I say, in South Africa, there's a full inquiry now. And we've been asked by the South African government to make submissions as to what we need to open up the sector. Because ITV should never have collapsed in Nigeria.